Hi, and a very warm welcome from me, your host, Phil Parker, to Essential Skills of NLP podcast number 42. So here we go. We're on meta models. We're on the final stretch of the meta model, which has lasted for the last few weeks. And what we're doing with the meta model, as we said before, is we're helping people to make better distinctions as to what is real, what is true, what is accurate, how their version of the world might differ from what's really happening. Because the more we're aware of reality and what's really going on, the better choices we can make, because we'll be basing it on accuracy rather than guesswork and opinion. So we're on the final stretch, as I said, which is distortions. Last time we looked at complex equivalences, you remember the because statements. Today we're going to look at something called lost performatives. Again, it's a quite complicated phrase, but what it really means is missing authority. Says who? So we're here statements where something is stated to be a truth, like it's wrong to earn too much money. And there's a little question that should arise in our head, which is, according to who? Says who? How do we know this? How do you know that? There's this sense that this has been given as a truth, but there's no reference to who said it. If you ever do any scientific research, everything you say has to be referenced, saying this is who said this. You can't just say, this is what I think. You have to constantly say other authorities in the field have already said this. But in normal conversation, we don't apply those rules. We just say, yeah, it's bad to do that. You shouldn't do that. It's wrong to do this. So in this example, it's wrong to earn too much money. Should have a little sneaking voice in our head that says who? According to who? According to what? We spend a lot of time living our lives from these kind of statements that have been passed down from generation to generation. Don't say anything too positive about yourself because that's arrogance. According to who? Or you shouldn't do those things. If you do, people will look at you in a funny way. According to who? So we want to identify these things that are stated as truth and start to unpack them and work out if the authority figure that has said this actually had a full idea of the way the world works. Because very often we'll get these half-truths given by people from a different time where society saw things in a different way. Or it may be a statement that applies to a general group of people. It doesn't particularly apply to us. We need to recover our power in this and decide whether we go along with this truth or not. Now, sometimes we may do. We may go, it's wrong to kill people. Okay, yeah, I would agree with that. And other times they may go, it's wrong to challenge authority. Well, there are certain times where that is exactly what you need to do. But we need to reclaim our choice in it, first of all, to discover what we want for ourselves, what's appropriate for us in this moment. So, lost performative, the missing authority, or more simply, says who? That's the question you want to ask yourself. Whenever you hear a statement that's presented as a truth, but it's not being attributed to anyone specifically, so therefore you can't challenge whether it's true or not, we need to check in and find out, right, who says this? Where does this come from? So that's lost performatives. Next up is a very, very common one, which I've referred to a number of times before, which is called mind reading. Mind reading is where somebody says something that they could only know by being able to read someone's mind, but they say it like it's true. Here's an example. She was happy that I was fat. She didn't like me because of my clothes. We need to ask, how do you know that? Usually the answer will be, I just do. I could tell. But what we're doing here is, yeah, we may be right, we may be intuiting it, but fundamentally, we're basing it on a guess, on a hunch. And sometimes our hunches are right, and sometimes they're not. Sometimes we can live into a belief system, an intuition we have about a situation that is completely wrong. So there's an example. Let's imagine you see someone in the morning, you wave at them, hi, how are you doing? And they completely ignore you. In your mind, you've mind read that means something. This means they don't like you. You've done something to offend them. They're specifically ignoring you on purpose. Maybe they just didn't see you. Maybe they had their iPod on listening to this podcast, and as a result, they didn't hear your shouting salutation. But if we live into, I know what this means, it means they don't like me or I've upset them, then we completely engage with that belief and that state, and we run our lives from that perspective. What we need to do with mind reading is catch it and then challenge it. How do we know that? Do we actually know that, or are we making that up by mind reading or thinking we know? And then potentially we've got the option of finding out if it's true or not, going to talk to the person. Now, sometimes we might be right, of course. But amazingly, there's lots of times when we're completely off base. Couldn't be further from the truth. And unless we clarify that, we will end up living in an unreal relationship to this person where we think they think something about us. Naturally, of course, our response then changes, and then they start to think something about us. Well, that person's being a bit cold to me. I wonder if I've upset them in some way. Or I wonder if they don't like me. Or I wonder if that's the kind of person. She didn't like me because of my clothes. We need to ask, how do you know that? Usually the answer will be, I just do. I could tell. But what we're doing here is, yeah, we may be right, we may be intuiting it, but fundamentally we're basing it on a guess, on a hunch. And sometimes our hunches are right and sometimes they're not. Sometimes we can live into a belief system, an intuition we have about a situation that is completely wrong. So there's an example. Let's imagine you see someone in the morning, you wave at them, hi, how are you doing? And they completely ignore you. In your mind, you've mind read that that means something. This means they don't like you. You've done something to offend them. They're specifically ignoring you on purpose. Maybe they just didn't see you. Maybe they had their iPod on listening to this podcast, and as a result, they didn't hear your shouting salutation. But if we live into, I know what this means, it means they don't like me or I've upset them, then we completely engage with that belief and that state, and we run our lives from that perspective. What we need to do with mind reading is catch it and then challenge it. How do we know that? Do we actually know that, or are we making that up by mind reading or thinking we know? And then potentially we've got the option of finding out if it's true or not, going to talk to the person. Now, sometimes we might be right, of course. But amazingly, there's lots of times when we're completely off base. Couldn't be further from the truth. And unless we clarify that, we will end up living in an unreal relationship to this person where we think they think something about us. Naturally, of course, our response then changes, and then they start to think something about us. Well, that person's being a bit cold to me. I wonder if I've upset them in some way. Or I wonder if they don't like me. Or I wonder if that's the kind of person they are. So we can see how relationships can quite easily start to spiral out of control, just as a result of this miscommunication, which starts from one person mind reading what is behind one person's behavior, and the other person then doing exactly the same. So that's mind reading. Watch out for that. People do that all the time. And I know as you listen to it, you're doing it. Of course, that's mind reading. Can't possibly know that. So watch out for mind reading. It's a really, really good way to create trouble. Check it out in yourself. Find out when you've done that. And also notice it. You'll find it in soap operas. You'll find it in news reports where people attribute the reasoning behind one person's done it, but with no knowledge of what that person is actually thinking. You'll find it in gossip columns. You'll find it in Hello magazine. All those kind of places. And of course, you'll find it in everyday conversation. And whenever you find it, you don't have to challenge it in other people, but you do need to challenge it in yourself. So that's our two little points from distortion today. There's one more we're going to cover next time. Keep in mind the lost performatives, the missing authority, when something is said to be true, but it's not attributed to anyone. And ask yourself, well, according to who? Says who? How do we know this? And then secondly, we've covered mind reading, so watch out for that. That's when we are assuming we know what somebody is thinking, and we are convinced of it. Watch out for that in yourself. Notice it in other people. You don't necessarily have to comment on it when other people are using it, but just recognize that they're stating something as truth, which is actually a guess. So until next time, you take care. Bye. If you've enjoyed these podcasts, you can get the rest of the entire series directly from the iTunes store. Simply search for me, Phil Parker, or Essential NLP to find it.